Isn't that good? We got, yeah, we got, we can probably say that.
Okay.
Well, and that's where the story ends.
Okay, we have a code for Atomic Heart. Actually, I'm not sure if we're live yet. I just know I pressed the go live button before you said that.
I'm going to be honest. I'm sure very glad that I led with a little intro.
Okay. I think we're live.
Hello, everyone.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to the post-CP stream. I'm Yahtzee Croshaw. I'm joined by Marty Sleaver.
Hello, hello.
And we're playing today's EP subject, Hi-Fi Rush. I hope you like the 90s butt rock we're currently listening to, because you'll be hearing an awful lot of that in the next 2 hours.
I'm glad. I like that this game seems to be made by someone who had, like, carte blanche over, I want the music I liked for this one specific decade to all be in the game. Yeah, and yeah. They were just like, yeah, sure. Yeah, we could do that. That's fine.
Yeah, I guess the fact that the final boss is to Nine Inch Nails sort of gives the game away as to what generation the creators were from.
Yeah, and it even does weird deep cuts. There's like there was a one-hit wonder supergroup that had Billy Corgan. It was led by Billy Corgan, the dude from Smashing Pumpkins.
Smashing Pumpkins, yeah.
Like Zahn or something, I believe they were called. And they showed up in the game. I'm like, I did not expect this to be here.
Just make sure we got streamer mode on. That's the last time you'll be hearing from Nine Inch Nails.
Okay. Well, Zwan, that was it, Lazarus. Thank you so much, Zwan. And welcome to everyone in the chat, everyone on YouTube, everyone on Twitch. Welcome to Toad-chan, been a member in Early Access. And Catchy Tomcat, welcome to the Tip Jar. E1 Craze for Life, for Stono of the Stream, $5. What kind of game is more annoying to you, a terrible indie game or an excellent AAA game? What? A terrible indie game is more annoying because an excellent AAA game is good.
It's excellent, and I would be really having fun.
That's like, there's no. The thing is, AAA should not equate to bad because there's good AAA and there's bad AAA.
No, quite.
This is funded by AAA, and this was good.
I'm not above admitting that I liked something.
Yeah. And Kid Barchetto with a $2 dono. Your TV tropes page is concerningly thorough.
Future. If you say so. Does it mention my inside leg measurement or something?
Well, that would be absolutely concerningly thorough. Are you done?
Well, anyway, if you don't know anything about Hi-Fi Rush, it's a rhythm action game.
Mm-hmm.
It's got combat along the lines of sort of Devil May Cry, Spectacle Fighter sort of area, and you have to do it in time with the beat.
Yep.
But it's also, the core of its appeal is in very pleasing animation as well.
And I think its entire style, its aesthetic, and its tone I like quite a bit. I think it understands exactly what it is and is not trying to be anything more or anything less than it is, which is very refreshing nowadays.
See if you can spot when the 2D animation switches to the cel-shaded 3D models. At the moment, it's 2D animation.
And Jumbly with a highlighted message. Thank you so much, Jumbly. Were you rushing or were you dragging during your first run?
Well, it depends, doesn't it? You do a bit of rushing and a bit of dragging as well.
I am a very visual person, so I kept you can hit select and it brings up the beat at the bottom of the screen, and I kept that on for most of the game. You'll see when you get to combat what I mean there.
Yeah, I guess I tend to get on with rhythm games because I can actually play rhythm games. I see a little comment saying, "Oh, I can't play rhythm games because I suck at rhythm." I guess that's not me. I do not suck at rhythm. I used to play expert at Guitar Hero level. Back when Guitar Hero was a thing.
Only 90s kids will remember when Guitar Hero was a thing. I think this game is pretty accommodating to people who have a bad sense of rhythm.
Yeah, well,
I don't think you necessarily need to have a good sense of rhythm to enjoy the game.
Yeah, it's very tutorial-y. And, they really push the rhythm, like the entire environment, everything that can animate, animates to the rhythm. It's very thorough. Mm-hmm.
And Tommy Salty with the 10 Zwoti donation. Thank you so much. What a time to be alive. Waka, waka. People are starting to get wise to our verbal quirks and catchphrases.
I see. We need people with influence. You know, it's funny because this game is sort of like a East and West co-production in that it was produced by Shinji Mikami's company, but the director was a Western guy, I think.
He's American, I believe John Johansson. He first worked on the original Evil Dead, or Evil Within, excuse me. Evil Dead is something else. He like directed the DLC, and then he directed Evil Within too. Jesus Christ, Evil Within, not Evil Dead.
And the interesting thing is that the same is true of Forspoken as well, last week's game.
Yeah.
There's a lot of Japanese names in the credits.
Yeah. Forspoken's a strange one. Leaf 5 up 6? I'm just going to go with that, with $5. When is Trilby getting a new game? 5 Days a Stranger.
Never.
Oh. Trilby.
Old character of mine.
Well, rest in peace, Trilby.
Hey, it's cel-shaded 3D models now. Did you spot the transition?
Oh, incredible. And Dread Hair 870, thank you so much, with $5. Can't stick around, just saying hi. Thank you so much, Dread Hair. And Gabriel Rodriguez with $5 dono. No comment, just $5 dono. Appreciate it, Gabriel.
Thank you very much. It's one of those games that's going to be awkward to stream because I have to focus on maintaining my rhythm. And it's hard to talk as well.
Also, that is also true. Put on easy. It'll be fine.
So even our running animation is in time with the beat, you'll know.
Yeah. You're going to see everything in the background. Lights flicker to the beat. Your HUD in the upper left-hand corner is moving to the beat. Steam pipes are going to burst to the beat. Platforms will extend and contract to the beat.
That hit the spot. What was your opinion on the main character Chai as a person?
I liked him quite a bit, especially in the orbit of the Forspoken discourse.
Well, he's a kind of an overconfident prat, but you're kind of supposed to think he's a prat.
Yeah, and I'd like the I end up liking him and the characters much better once you are slowly folding in the rest of the his crew.
Did you notice this little background detail? There's an imprint of Chai's body on the fence he got thrown against.
It's pretty good.
Nice attention to detail this game's got. Did I mention I quite like it? Did you see my review? I quite liked it.
I didn't, but I've heard you talk about it several times. I'm glad. I'm glad. Coming off a week where you did not enjoy a game, I'm glad you got to enjoy a game. Yeah, it's it feels like refreshingly simple, in a way that a lot of the games we loved of the late 90s and aughts were. A lot of people are drawing comparisons to sort of the Dreamcast, to PS2, to Xbox,
radio,
GameCube
Jet
era.
Set radio sort of area. And I'm reminded
and
of
even the stuff Capcom and, well, even the stuff Capcom and Mikami and Clover were doing at the time.
Yeah, there's a lot of parallels to God Hand in that the main character has a replaced arm and a scarf.
Yeah. I think this game is less rough around the edges than God Hand was.
That's possible.
And
try to tap my foot in time with the beat, that'll help.
There you go. And Pablo Cardona, thank you so much for the donation. 40,000 COP. Do you know what COP are?
Nope.
We're going to find out together. Dun 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 dun. Colombian pesos, thank you so much. Finally caught a stream live. Thanks for all the laughs over the years. Thank you so much, Pablo.
See, that entire sequence was also happening in time to the beat, if you were paying attention.
Yeah, it's impressive how much thought was seemingly put into every little aspect of the game. Dogmatic Director with a $5 donation. I love the animation switching to animating on twos when emphasizing movement. I wish more games put that amount of love into animation in a game. And Marcus, thank you so much for $5 Australian. I'm impressed by how well they made 3D art look like 2D art. It's weird how little we see this opposed to that Borderlands style halfway look. Yeah, and I'm getting pretty sort of burnt out on the Borderlands-y look, and so having this sort of drop into our laps all of a sudden was very refreshing.
Because they can't fight the urge to do a whole bunch of shading on the cell shading as well.
Yeah.
Or texturing. That's Borderlands' problem. It's cell shaded, but with texturing as well, because someone in the art team needed to look busy. Second. Cell shading needs flat color. Flat!
I think there's also a fear with that, since they're in so in the AAA space, that they're like, we can't ostracize anyone, we need to appeal to everyone. Whereas this game feels very confident in being like, well, if you don't like it, then you can just move on.
Yeah.
And as a reminder, we are accepting donations all this week for the Trans Lifeline charity through our Tiltify. You guys have already raised over $5,300, which is incredible. Dropping the link in there. Donations in there go to the Trans Lifeline charity. Most recent one, Dower Dodger, thank you so much, with a $100 donation. Absolutely incredible.
Yes, this is us offsetting the fact that we're reviewing Hogwarts Legacy in a couple of weeks.
Not next week. Next week is Dead Space, correct? Some people were curious of what's next week.
Yes, next week is the Dead Space remake. It's funny, like, for the last few weeks or so, something's come out in time that I could start on it, like, halfway through the week.
Yeah, it's kind of a when it rains, it pours scenario. It feels like the first couple of weeks of the year, we were in like a holding pattern, and now I'm just drowning in games I want to play.
I finished playing Hi-Fi Rush in time that I could start playing Dead Space in the same week, and last week Hogwarts Legacy came in, so I could play it after I'd finished Dead Space, and this week I finished Hogwarts Legacy now, but we've just got the Atomic Heart code, so I'm starting on that probably after this.
Look at that. And it's also nice that this, and I'm assuming the Dead Space remake, given the first one, aren't overly long. This is in and out of your life within 8 hours or so, I would say, maybe less.
Yeah, pretty much.
A couple people have mentioned Pizza Tower. Do you know about Pizza Tower?
Not really.
It is an indie PC game that just came out a few weeks ago, and it is heavily inspired by the Wario Land games.
Huh.
I'm not WarioWare, Wario Land, like the platforming games.
Well, WarioWare, what's the good ones?
Well, Wario Land's great. What are you talking about? Have you played Wario Land?
No.
Okay, Wario Land is wonderful, so highly recommended. Pizza Tower is on PC. I'm going to wait. I'm hoping they put it on Switch. I don't want to set up my computer. My computer's for taxes, and that's it. Ozymandias, King of Kings, says Yahtzee. Will you make a review of Metroid Prime?
Well, depends how dead things get this year, I suppose. I mean, to check out that Wanted Dead thing that everyone seems to hate.
You know who doesn't? Casey Wosu.
Oh, okay.
Casey Wosu is the world's number one Wanted Dead fan. I have a feeling Wanted Dead is going to be it's going to be a cult hit. I have a feeling it's going to have a rabid... Speaking of God Hand, I have a feeling that's going to enter God Hand status.
Well, that's what makes it interesting to me, I guess.
Yeah. I've been playing Metro Prime Remastered, let me tell you. Incredible. Oh my god. So pretty. Pendragon with a $2 donation. Thank you so much, Pendragon. Watching this while sipping a chai latte. I like how everyone in this game is named after food. Except for 808, who's named after an 808.
And Corsica.
Who's
Unless that's a kind of fancy cheese I'm not aware of.
That could be, yeah.
Everyone's named after food that associates with hipsters in some way.
Chai. Do you associate chai with hipsters? I guess tea.
Yeah, yeah. Well, tea I associate with hipsters, yes.
Yeah.
chai, peppermint, kale, peppermint, macaroni.
Peppermint is not on hipsters. I had peppermint as a child. Well,
I
let
still
me tell
associate
you.
It with tea.
Macaron.
Yeah, that's very hipstery, macarons.
Yeah. Mimosa. Mimosas are great. I'm not gonna abide by any mimosa slander here.
Man, when I was playing this with it, when I wasn't on stream, I could get like the little exclamation mark bubble on it basically every single beat. Just the fact that I'm playing on stream fucks up my rhythm. I blame you.
Yeah, I mean, when you were playing alone, I'm assuming you weren't trying to engage in off-the-cuff jibber jabber.
See, that's how it's supposed to work. You get the little hey every time you press to the beat.
Yep. Oh, so if you hit select, that was the thing I was talking about. Did you never have that little thing at the bottom?
Hmm?
If you hit select.
Oh, that thing.
I had that the whole... I needed this the whole game. Because let me tell you.
No, I completely forgot this was... I completely forgot this was an option. I didn't play the game with this at all. And I still A-ranked basically every level. Except the final boss. Final boss was really hard.
Final boss is very tough. My favorite thing was because at the end of each encounter, it usually gives you three grades, and I liked getting an A, an S, and an S because it's spelled S. Yeah, literally made me laugh every time. So, yes. Truly the gift that keeps on giving.
If there's six, you could theoretically spell out badass.
But that'd be great.
You'd have to work very hard.
You'd have to like purposely throw one aspect of the fight. Poseidon Energy, but I remember for 18 months. Thank you so much, Poseidon Energy. I was unsure of this game initially, but now I'm all in. The animation is so pretty, and the physical gags are really, actually really funny and well-timed.
Yeah.
Very charming.
There's a lot of humor based around Chai being kind of a twat so far, which didn't always work for me, but I liked the physical humor when he gets smashed into things.
Yeah.
I like it when he's in pain.
And I will say the game, to me, the interactions become more and more interesting as you meet your pals. Pretty much at like every major stage, you gain a new ally, and not only do they expand the combat and the puzzles, very loose definition of puzzles, but
the combat keeps expanding. There's constantly new enemies being introduced. It never feels grindy.
One dumb thing, I'm gonna say. One thing I'm not a fan of. After you finish the game, you unlock the ability to purchase a bunch of cosmetics to change how you look and all your partners look. Why not have those in the game themselves? Because I finished the game and I was like, these are really cool costumes. I don't know if I'm going to go back and do this all.
Yeah, I wasn't sure about that. That's also when you unlock the character gallery and all of that stuff.
Although maybe, again, like if we're still going along with the whole, you know, it's really... has the hallmarks of a game of that generation. Like Resi 4 was the same way. I'm playing through Resident Evil 4 again, and you don't get to unlock all the weird shit until you finish the game once. Kind of expects you to play it again. And Marcus Moyad, thank you so much for $2 Australian. Gotta be productive. Bye, lads. You know what? If you have to leave, the only way any of you are allowed to leave is to pay us, so thank you for doing that.
Hey, well, S rank for time, at least.
There you go.
Yeah, well, I don't know why my timing sucks so much when I'm having to listen to you talk. It doesn't feel like it should be as bad as this. Maybe I need to turn the game volume up, but if I did that, we wouldn't be able to hear our lovely voices.
Is there a... for streaming for some reason? Is there like a slight input lag?
Well, I shouldn't be experiencing that just looking at the game.
And I imagine you shouldn't, but who knows how computers work? I know. Glazer says I'd kill for this to be on Switch. Seems like a great fit. It does, except for the fact that it was made by Microsoft.
Oh, yes.
Yes, that old chestnut.
It's on Steam, though, isn't it?
I think Microsoft has been fine with their games going to Steam, though. I don't think they're...
Well, as I keep saying, Xbox is just PC gaming, isn't it?
Yeah. And I mean, again, I think a large reason why this game sort of was able to hit so hard while being shadow dropped is, the quality of the game, but also I mean, Game Pass. So a 25-30 million built-in audience was able to download this game
immediately
and try it out. And it's a game that, you know, once you play or watch other people play, it's a it makes a very good first showing.
It's a very immediately appealing game.
Yeah, and who knows how we would have thought if it would have went through the, you know, standard press cycle of being teased last summer, and then we get the first gameplay trailer, and then there's a hands-on event, and 100 different journalists talk about the game hands-on, and then we have to wait for it to come out.
I'm glad that didn't happen.
I am also glad that didn't happen.
As I said in the review, though, the fact that they released it with such confidence implies that they know damn well that most of what they give us is garbage. They knew this shit was good. That's why they didn't hype it. Tells you a little something about games they hype, doesn't it?
Oh no. All right, so I'll keep this quick. Dun dun dun.
Robot cat. I think
we might be 808. Each other.
I thought security's all over you. Which I assume it's like a pun on Bob, right? Like the cat's called Bob, but his name is spelled out in numbers.
Oh no, an 808 is like a beat machine, like a little electronic machine that you make beats on.
Oh, so it works on multiple levels.
It does. Look at that.
It could also be Bob.
The chai drinking baby hipster finally coming out. Dude, listen. Vandalay's up to something, and I said I can help. Thanks, but I'm good. Redbeer, been a member for 7 months. Thank you so much, Redbeer. But the Ori games were published by Xbox and released on Switch. I think it'll eventually come to Switch. I don't think they see it as a competition. Ori, Cuphead. Ori and Cuphead were published by Xbox, not developed. I believe Minecraft is, and the Minecraft adjacent games are the only first party Xbox games that have made their way to.
Yeah, those are doing so well, aren't they?
People love the Minecrafts. Oh my god.
They love Minecraft vanilla, but they keep trying to make like Minecraft spin offs and they all suck.
Oh. There was a Minecraft Diablo, now they're doing like a Minecraft tower defense thing. Yeah. I don't know what's going on with these Minecrafts. I don't like them. Everyone's too square.
Timing circle. Oh yes, this is the extra thing.
I like that everyone is thinking the same way as me. The corporation is named the Vandalay Corporation. That's the last name of the bad guys, and I could only think of Art Vandalay and Vandalay Industries from Seinfeld. I'm imagining it is a reference to Seinfeld.
If you think so.
I do.
You know, I was seeing like comments saying that, oh, how ironic that this game with the anti-corporate message was made by one of the world's biggest corporations. But I got to the end of the game, and you know, when you get to the end of the game, this game actually gets pretty pro-corporate. It's like, oh, actually, it was just the CEO being evil. It was this one bad apple. And when the nice person takes over the corporation, suddenly everybody loves it, and the corporation only does good things.
I mean, that's like Call of Duty games in a nutshell are like, whoa, military isn't bad. There's just occasionally a bad apple who ruins things, so you gotta take over the bad apple.
A lot of people say bad apple without acknowledging the rest of the phrase. A single bad apple ruins the whole barrel. Which means if there's a bad apple, you should probably chuck them all out.
Are you telling me that I should be worried about the American military-industrial complex?
Well, I and... well, who's that president that had a big speech against the industrial complex that has proved to be absolutely right?
Probably Taft. He was a big dude.
No, it was like a 20th century dude. But yeah,
Taft, then.
I and that guy are against the military-industrial complex, yes.
Just you two. That's a very brave stance to take. Got a lot of Eisenhower. Shout out to Eisenhower fans in the crowd.
Yeah. I guess that was it then.
You're getting Dwight D-splained by everybody. Dude, I agree. So the weirdest thing is I got to, this game has a Xenogears reference, and I got to the Xenogears reference on the day I started a Xenogears replay for the first time after like 25 years, so very strange. More people, please type the word Eisenhower in. We haven't had enough Eisenhower yet, so please, everyone band together and explain Eisenhower. Gather around. Crimson Vulps with a $5 dono. I found a copy of the Hornblower miniseries at a thrift store. I'm halfway through and I adore it. Would love to listen to Ben talk about the books.
Who's this Ben person you people
first name
about?
Basis.
Well, if you were really someone I was friends with, you would know that nobody calls me Ben, because it pisses me off.
Oh, dun dun dun. Maybe it's an enemy. Think about that. Is that how Kylo Ren, do you know who Kylo Ren is? I've even brought up
Kylo
Ren. Yes,
I know who Kylo Ren is. I live on the internet.
Did you know Kylo Ren's actual name is Ben, and he doesn't like it when people call him Ben?
Yes, I'm aware.
Yeah, so maybe you're like our little Kylo Ren. King Dad with a $5 donation, thank you so much. But the power structure isn't the problem, we just need the right people in power.
There's a saying going around concerning something that corrupts and corrupts absolutely.
Can't put my finger on it.
One that literally says QA Center on it.
People now like the name Kylo Kroshaw.
They're probably expecting you, so you and me have out. Let's go.
You know, one other thing? I think Chai should have been a little bit faster. Just his movement speed in general should be a little bit faster.
Sounds like you didn't know to use the grappling hook in combat a lot.
No, I'm not talking about combat. I'm talking about right now. Like, running around. My speed in combat's fine. It's mostly because I was doing a lot of, like what you're doing right now, I was doing a lot of puttering. I was doing a lot of, ooh, I want to explore that corner. I want to see what's going on. I feel like I should have been a smidge faster. And maybe it's because the game stylistically and tonally resembles Sunset Overdrive so much, and you can be very fast in that game.
You,
listen, I'm not going to bring up Sunset Overdrive.
Bloody Overdrive.
Listen, we all have our games. If we had a nickel for every time you brought up Silent Hill 2, a lot of nickels. A large number of nickels.
Well, that's a good game. Yeah, I said it.
You monster. Well, hope you choke on your remake coming later this year.
I certainly will.
We'll see. I think by the end of this year, you're going to pull a full 180 and you're going to become Remake's biggest fan. You're just going to love Remakes. You want everything being remade.
Well, I was reminded as I was writing my Dead Space Remake script, that we're always saying don't remake shit that's already good, remake stuff that had potential that it didn't quite reach.
Yes.
And I think that's what the Dead Space remake benefits from, and which the Silent Hill 2 remake absolutely will not.
And Resident Evil 4.
Though I fell.
I like that the game is a punishing for falling. I appreciate that. Snake of the Garden with a €2 donation. Thank you so much, Snake. Something military industrial complex. To be honest, if I came in halfway through the stream and just saw all the Eisenhowers in the chat and the military industrial complex, I'd be like, what happened to this stream?
You know, I was actually noticing that too. Finding the beat is as simple as looking around.
I do feel he doesn't jump very far, does old Chai. He doesn't get much distance with his height.
Yeah.
I'd usually misjudge how far he was jumping and have to, like, dodge forward as well. I think this is what those
young people call being. Yeah, it feels like his movement was very much catered to combat, and the combat arenas being relatively small. And they kept that core movement for these, like, sort of bigger, more exploratory sections. And James Hunt, been a member for 8 months, using the early access comp to say, can't wait for new Adventure Is Nigh episodes. Well, you're not going to have to wait too much longer, James.
Well,
Season 3, in person in a month and a half.
And Side Quest 2 will be coming out at some point.
I mean, I don't want to show you how the sausage is made. I believe it's possible there's an episode of Side Quest Season 2 being filmed at this very moment.
Serious?
Which,
well, no wonder they had to
distract me. You might be able to detract two people who aren't in it. No, no, spoilers. We're not in it. Because we're here.
No, it's not. Yeah, I rolled well on that thing in Season 2, and that means I don't get to be in the side quest, apparently.
You rolled too well. That was your problem. You're too good at Dungeons & Dragons.
It's my curse.
Yeah, it was funny seeing people who just sort of looked at Tango Gameworks' previous games were like, how did they go from the Evil Within spooky realistic games to this?
It was Evil Within, and then they made Ghostwire Tokyo, didn't they?
And Ghostwire Tokyo, yeah. Well, both Evil Within games and then Ghostwire Tokyo. But yeah, I mean, Mikami's done plenty of Mikami has had thumbprints on Piano 3 and Beautiful Joe.
Yeah, P&O 3, the game that, the game from the Capcom 5 that nobody liked.
No. Although, again, like, the fact that in that game, she moves to the beat of the music, and she's constantly tapping her foot.
She looked like she was busting for a piss, if you ask me.
Well, maybe that's what Chai looks like right now when he's not moving. I think
he's also snapping his fingers. You don't snap your fingers when you're busting for a piss.
You gotta stop saying busting. You need to stop saying bust.
It's a phrase in perfectly common parlance. I'm busting for a piss, one says.
Nope.
To mean I desperately need to go to the lavatory.
Nope. I think busting has been co-opted by the sickos. Jumbly says, don't forget Disney's The Lion King for the SNES. Did not work on The Lion King. Worked on Aladdin and Goof Troop. And I could never forget Lion King because that game.
Shinji Mikami did.
Shinji Mikami, first two games were Aladdin and Goof Troop.
Well, well, well.
Yeah.
Gotta start somewhere.
And then they were like, hey, let's put this man in a spooky mansion and make him shoot zombos. And it worked well.
Two people independently did the Bustin' Makes Me Feel Good joke. And another one on Twitch as well.
Oh my god.
Three people on YouTube saying Bustin' Makes Me Feel Good.
We've got so many busters here.
You're all so bloody predictable sometimes, aren't you?
Says us who have the visual tics. If anything is said, one of us will say if you like or waka waka. Crimson Volps with a Vile Ardono, thank you so much. Didn't know you despise that name. I'll know better next time. That was in reference to calling you Ben.
Good. Be filled with shame. Okay, I'll just stay here then. Ow.
Hey, cool. What's that?
I wouldn't touch that. Well, you're not dead.
Pablo Cardona, thank you so much for the donation. Yachts, do you think D&D makes you better at writing?
I wouldn't say there's much connection to that. Maybe being good at writing makes me good at D&D. I think D&D is good for coming up with ideas.
I also think it's strong. I feel like D&D can help with communal storytelling. With becoming good at working in a team.
It makes you good at improv storytelling.
Yeah.
A key part of improv storytelling is knowing when to relinquish control and let other people have input.
Mm-hmm.
And that's something you learn a lot playing D&D.
Agreed.
It's like yes-anding the game.
Mm-hmm. I think that's why Jack's so good at it. And Hun Bullseye with a highlight message over on Twitch says Sunima Mina Waka Waka That was a Shakira reference. You a big Shakira fan?
No.
Okay. Do you like Fozzie Bear from the Muppets?
No.
Alright.
That's an example of the opposite of yes Andy.
Yeah, that was no perioding. Hunter asks, are we in streamer mode? Correct.
Sure are. Right. This game has a lot of original music that replaces the licensed music in streamer mode. It's not like those shitty games that just mute all the music if you're in streamer mode.
Silence. been a lot of people. Dunzel's the latest, asking if this game's going to be in your top five or your number one for the year. And I feel like that's like, y'all are already thinking about the ride home when we're like at the first quarter of an event.
People always...
Just enjoy the rest of the event. Don't worry about that till the end of the year.
Yeah, people always ask that. Oh, is this going to be in the end of the year? It's like they want to place bets.
Yeah.
They want to go to the betting shop.
Gambling. Gambling addicts and deviants.
I want my grappling hook back. It's the best way to deal with projectile users.
It's very nice.
Well, I got an A for timing on that one. Maybe I'm getting better.
I mean, because you also, you finished playing this game a while ago, right? A couple weeks
ago. Yeah, like 2 weeks ago, because as I say, I'm keep getting ahead of schedule with releases. Like, I'm going to be... Like, as I say, I've already finished Hogwarts Legacy, and I haven't even don't even have to start the review for that till next week.
What's your normal what's your normal schedule? Do you have like a set day? I think Monday you usually write, right? Because you're just saying it's like something else that you're writing, right?
Well, on Monday and Tuesday I write in the mornings and play games in the afternoons.
Yeah.
Wednesday to Friday I make zero punctuation assets in the mornings and play games in the afternoons. Everything else, I just squeeze in wherever it'll fit.
Gotcha. So you generally do worky work stuff in the morning, and then in the afternoons you play the games for the work.
Yes, I'd worky work in the Funky Bunch.
Ah! I was gonna say you work in the morning and then play games in the afternoon, but playing the games is part of the work.
Playing the games is work, and by Christ,
you don't
does
have
it feel
you don't
like
have
it
any work.
Point.
You don't play the games.
Yes, people envy a game reviewer's job, but it certainly starts to feel like work after a while, playing video games all day.
All work feels like work.
Because, of course, if it's not your job, you have the option of stopping if you're not having fun.
That is very true. That is very true. So what we're saying is our jobs are as hard as coal miners.
Yes.
That's what
No one appreciates how difficult our lives are.
Yeah. We get that coal miner lung.
We get video game wrist. That's what we get. There have been many documented cases of people getting actual injuries in video games. There was that.
I worked with a lot of people at IGN who had like chronic wrist injuries.
Yeah, there was that dude who played like with a vibrating controller too much, like 12 hours a day. He ended up getting like a hand disease that had previously only been seen in workers who used pneumatic drills.
Oh my god, that's not good. Black lung, that was the disease I was thinking of. Speakeasy, thank you.
Lots of hidden secrets in this game. Check every nook and cranny.
You know who my favorite character I would stumble across often was?
Was it the two robots who looked like the characters from the Evil Within?
Evil Within, yeah, like the HR detective.
Yeah.
I like them.
I remember thinking, that's going to go over a lot of people's heads.
Yeah.
No, I can't imagine there's much crossover between the audience for the Evil Within and the audience for this.
I mean, if you like good games, that's the only crossover. Content-wise, not so much. What do you think of the Evil Within? I don't know if I've ever talked about it with you.
I wasn't a huge fan.
Either one?
Not really. I thought they suffered from a lack of subtlety and a lack of coherence in the way the story played out. At least the first one did. Power's out. And the second one was just kind of dumb.
Any tools nearby?
Tools? I got a better idea.
And you weren't crazy about Ghostwire Tokyo either, correct?
No, but then few people were.
This guy was. Because I'm an idiot.
Because you're a weeb, as we know.
I'm a weeb. Yes. it was nice during the pandemic to be like, oh, it's Tokyo. I miss Tokyo.
Does any game set in Brisbane?
Man, there's not a lot of games set in Australia to begin with. There's like that. There's the one Forza game.
There's games set in the Bay Area, like Watch Dogs Legion, but it stops at Berkeley. So it never depicted any of the places I've ever lived.
You never lived in the city?
Not in the city, no. I've been mainly in the East Bay area. That's a very like Northern California native thing to do, isn't it? To say the city when you mean San Francisco.
It is. Yeah, we did it. We did it. We excluded our audience. Proud of us. Christian Hansen with $6.99 Canadian dollars. Thank you so much. Are you guys generally optimistic or pessimistic about video games' future in society? Oh, as entertainment and art form.
Well, I guess I try not to judge. But, you know, my sense has always been, if you stay pessimistic, you can only ever be pleasantly surprised.
And my sentiment is, if you're optimistic, everything seems, the sun shines a little bit brighter. There you go. No, I think the future, like...
Oh, bugger.
I think there are more good games every year. Or there's as many good games now every year as there were before. There's probably more terrible games now than there's ever been. But if you look outside the AAA space, the industry is thriving with creativity and with passion and with entertaining games and with heartfelt games.
It's a lot of shitty games just because there's a lot of games generally.
Just like there's a lot of shitty movies. King Dad with a $5 dono. Thank you so much, King Dad. Does anyone else remember the GE Clean Coal commercial playing 16 tons with sexy coal miners from 15 years ago? I don't know. That sounds terrifying.
But rock.
You love your butt rock.
When I'm in the mood.
Rhythm games are too hard. I want to relax, but you gotta time it right. Michael Wolf with a $5 donation. Thank you so much, Michael. Marty and Yahtzee, did you papers, please, and Return to the Obra Dinn are on PS5? Thoughts?
Good for them. I hope they make more money.
Well, I'm not sure. I don't think Papers, Please is on the PS5.
I thought they were trying to. He was trying to inform us that they were.
I'm not sure. I know. I'm pretty sure Oberdin's on PlayStation. So I hope it came out on PlayStation. I think when it came to Switch and everything. So I highly recommend everyone play Return of the Oberdin. Papers, Please. I'm not sure. I don't even know if Papers, Please is on consoles.
There was a tablet version, which was basically the perfect version for that.
Which I loved. That is one of those perfect games that almost excels with tangibility to it. Fungus Finder with a $2 dono. Thank you so much. Yahtzee, favorite Rinse World book? Lost Continent? Ring World book? Or is Rinse World a thing?
Rinse Wind. From this
Rinse
world.
Wind. Oh, Rinse Wind. That was me. I did that. That was a Marty typo.
Interesting times, like I keep saying. Like it should be.
Mandevil says I was trying to shut down Michael Wolf's whole point you've been trying to make for an hour. I don't understand. What the point he was trying to make was, we like Return of the Obra Dinn. We talk about it a lot. We probably talk about it too much, but that's fine because it's very good. Sam Lipton, been a member for 25 months. Thank you so much. How about an 808 spinoff a la Daxter? That's a prequel. I can get behind that. Did you ever play Daxter for the PSP?
Sounds I did.
All right. Do you know, did you play the Jak and Daxter games that weren't on PSP?
Can't say I did that either.
Oh man, they were great.
That was a little blind spot in my gaming experience. I never played the Jak and Daxter games.
That was Naughty Dog pre-Uncharted.
Yes.
Developed by Naughty Dog himself.
Never really was into that whole mascot platformer.
Oh man.
Of things.
That was one of my favorites. And we got Anonymous with a $20 donation over on Tiltify. Thank you so much, Anonymous. I'm assuming it's not the scary Anonymous that was trying to shut down Wall Street. Remember those guys?
I remember they kind of needed better messaging.
Yeah, it was a little diluted. Andre Dream, thank you so much for the donation. Watching the angry video game nerd is a nice reminder that most games released are crappy.
Well, that sounds like a good way to make yourself very cynical, Andre Dream. Keep it
up. There's so many good games, though. There's so many good games. There's too many good games.
A lot of them in the past. In fact, now that I think about it, all of them in the past, because that's how causality works.
Ooh. Dr. Zebra with a $2 dono, thank you so much. Yahtzee and Marty, what are your favorite desserts?
Cheese.
You seem like a tartman. Oh, I thought you were going to say tarts.
I like the combination of cherries with other desserts.
Oh man,
I like
cherry cheesecake.
I like Black Forest Gatto.
Okay.
I'm generally fond of cherry as a flavor.
What's Gatto?
Cake. It is a fancy cake.
Oh,
it is the French
word. No,
it's
a Japanese word for cake. Oh, it's a Japanese word for cat.
It's the French word for cake.
Oh. How come cake and cat are the same word in different languages?
They're spelled differently.
Talk amongst yourselves. Is it? Oh, it's not G-A-T-O?
No. It's G-A-T-E-A-U-X.
In my defense, a lot of people in the chat also associated gatto with cats. Also,
well, they are a bunch of weebs.
There's a lot of weebs. They are a bunch of weebs.
Let's not forget.
Yeah.
See, just like I thought. This isn't a boss arena. You need to relax.
Oh, Spanish for cat, not Japanese for cat. Why did I say Japanese? I always got Japan in the brain.
Oh no.
Yeah, so what song is going to play now? I'm very curious. Like,
what was it in non-streamer mode?
There was two Nine Inch Nails songs in the game. I think the first boss, if this is the big robot, it was Nine Inch Nails as well.
Okay.
I think the game opens with Black Keys, and then I believe this boss fight is Nine Inch Nails.
Yes.
And Katora Cowboy, thank you so much for the donation. Yahtzee, are you planning to review Like a Dragon Isshin?
As to repeat myself, depends on how dead things get. But I've got Dead Space Remake, Hogwarts Legacy, Atomic Heart, and Wanted Dead on the list so far.
That takes you all the way to March 22nd.
And then I'm out of town. I mean, I don't know what I'm going to do.
Oh, yeah, then you're out of town for like 2 weeks almost.
I'm not going to do is not sure what we're going to do with zero punctuation for that time. I'll need to talk to Nick about it.
Frost do it.
He'll probably just nag me to write like 500 extra punctuations for that period, like he usually does.
Vintage Nick. You know who I missed? Nick. Nick isn't in the chat. I miss him.
Oh, really? I
see his little message pop up. No.
He usually is, because he's terrified I'll say something that will get him into another Twitter flame war.
Yeah. Understandable. Oh, that's bad. Understandable. Also, by that time in March, I don't know if you guys knew this, a bunch of other games are going to come out as well. So, there's a lot of games coming out. Wolong? That's coming out. The new Bayonetta. Mini Bayonetta. Resi 4. Something called Dredge that I think has boats. And God knows you love your fucking boats.
His hands are extra sensitive for inspecting.
Bear Bomb, been a member for 13 months. Thank you so much. Favorite companion character. Hashtag Team Macaron. I think Macaron was probably mine.
I don't know. I liked Corsica's accent.
I liked Corsica's accent, too. I like everyone. Not a weak member among on the bunch. I like the robot. Your robot bunch.
Yeah, the robot was funny. Yeah, they're all pretty good.
Draws his little emotions on his face.
Oh, I fucked up.
Oh, that's funny. I think you're great. Beast March with a $2 dono. The idea of no ZPs for 2 weeks makes me depressed.
Well, it sort of cheers me up in Counterpoint.
Think of it as allowing him to have a... Well, it's not even a vacation, because it's working.
No, I went to get a vacation from work by doing some different work.
Yes. But think of how inspired he'll be after visiting the fine folks of Milwaukee.
Oh, yeah. I'll suddenly have come up with all sorts of new interesting swear words to describe things.
Jason Foley with a 10 euro donation. Thanks so much, Jason. Says, "Hey Yachts, I'm really considering getting this game after all the good reviews, but I've never played a rhythm game before. Are they hard to get into, being that you have to attack in time with music?"
I guess this is about as accessible as they're ever gonna get. So get this one, and then if you fuck it up, then rhythm games aren't for you.
Yeah, and there are a lot of accessibility options and difficulty levels, and also you will attack regardless if you attack in time with the beat. It's just your attack and your combo will get higher and you'll get more damage and there's certain things you need to block.
Yeah, you'll get more S ranks.
Yeah.
Like, I'm sucking at this right now.
Yeah.
I'm a flat D at the moment.
Hubba hubba. Damien says, "Marty, do you ever need to apologize when people say they're visiting your city? I do when people tell me they're coming to mine. St. Louis, the only thing I recommend is the zoo." I really like Milwaukee, so I'm not worried at all. And if my coworkers and friends don't like Milwaukee, then I'll just never stream with them again. So it's pretty much that simple. Nick Prime, been a member 24 months in early access. What did you say to start a Twitter flame war?
Nick just, I don't know if it was entirely my fault, but Nick got into a big old argument with some, you know, transphobic people. Which we probably shouldn't dwell on.
You know what we should dwell on? The fact that we've raised over $5,400.
Oh, yeah. That's mud in there, right?
Beast March with a $2 dono. Thank you so much. I forgot the break was for Adventurers Nigh. Never mind.
Yeah.
See?
I'm sure Nick will be expecting some like extra punctuation columns as well while I'm there. He usually does.
Dumbly with a highlight message. "I'll bite Yahtzee. What's up with the grappling hook joke in the video?"
Well, there's a grappling hook in this game, and I really like grappling hooks.
Grappling hook, okay.
Which was why I liked Halo Infinite, despite myself.
I feel like that's like an easy, like, if you implement a fun grappling hook, I will overlook a lot in your game.
Yeah.
And John Lee said, "Okay, more seriously, is this the best rhythm game out there on the market?"
Ooh.
I mean, it depends if you, like, what you're looking for. I feel like this is a very different thing than, like, Hellsinger, BPM, or
there's a lot,
Hyrule.
Yeah, there's a lot of experimental ones in, like, the indie spheres. Mm-hmm. So I was saying in this review, I can't remember a rhythm game I didn't like, but then after the review, I remembered one. There was an indie game called Soundfall, came out not too long ago, that I kind of bounced off. which was a rhythm action game, much like this, but it kind of sucked. But yeah, BPM, Metal Hellsinger, I usually get along well with rhythm games. Rhythm action games.
Yeah, a couple of people were bringing up this game No Straight Roads, which I know of but never played. Which
yeah, I reviewed that.
Pretty similar to this.
Yeah, it doesn't really front load the rhythm as well as this game does.
Yeah.
In fact, I dispute that game's a rhythm game at all. It's just got, you know, a prominent soundtrack.
Interesting. Is that a game that's just like a boss rush mode?
Yeah. It basically is just a sequence of boss fights.
And Fungus Finder again. Thank you so much for the $5 dono. I'm saving interesting times. Precious few left unread. Ever once hear of Battlefield 2142 and its Titan mode? Only first-person shooter I enjoyed. Thanks again.
Okay.
Saving interesting times. Precious few left unread. Is that a book of yours?
Yeah. Times. Precious. It's few. One of the Discworld books that I've mentioned that I like.
But every song's gotta end.
I don't know, I think I prefer the Nine Inch Nails song. I like the owl on the robot's forehead.
That's pretty good. Dr. Zebra, I also got heavy for the coolie vibes while playing this. Sorry, Yahtzee, cover your ears, we're talking weed.
Oh no!
Oh,
don't
get it all over
that.
Me! Geldon with a $2 dono. Thank you so much. Most stylish rhythm games since Space Channel 5.
Yeah, that turns out there's quite a few rhythm games now we think about it.
5's got a VR version. Rhythm in VR.
I quite like Ragnarok. That's like a VR rhythm game where you're playing a drum on a Viking longboat.
Oh, that's neat.
And they play a load of like Viking and dwarf metal and shit.
Hmm.
See, on my first run through, I got a rank A for the whole episode, and now I'm a straight B student because you people keep talking and distracting me from the beat.
Mm.
You
how's
scum.
It feel to get, how does it feel that you're worse at games than you were a few weeks ago?
Well, I've sort of come to terms with the fact that I'm past my physical peak.
I am absolutely worse at games than I was. Oh my god. Play the Resident Evil 4 now. Anytime a QTE comes up, even if I'm expecting it, I'm like, whoop! I fucked up everyone the first time.
I'm at the age where I basically just keep attracting little aches and pains, and they just never go away, and I have to live with them forever.
Your little Katamari.
Just
keep gobbling them up.
Yeah.
Are you scared? What?
No.
Kate Brockhausen with the $2 donation says Rockford, best boss for self-evident reasons. And
okay.
Kate Brockhausen has a wolf picture.
Is it because you like cheese? Is that why you like Rockford?
I think it was because Rockford turned into a wolf robot.
Oh, that guy. Yeah.
Yeah.
Hello? Catbot?
And Mia Pickle with $5 Canadian. Thank you so much. So to get instant recommendation from Yachts is to have a grappling hook, a boat, and play Kickstart My Heart.
And as long as it's like a rhythm action game. Grappling hook, boat, rhythm action game, Kickstart My Heart. Yeah, there's your game jam criteria right there. Also jetpack.
Jetpacks are good.
Why does Peppermint put us in a trap and point a gun at us? I mean, she knew we were coming in here.
Wait, okay, she's yours. She's yours.
Real violent.
Get up, slacker. We've got work to do.
This is another parallel with God Hand. main female sport character who mainly just fucks with the main character for giggles. We're gonna help me get
out of here. I am. Right after you help me look into Spectra.
I don't even know what that is.
Don't expect you to. This is whistleblower level.
So actually, I didn't really like Peppermint as a character. I think she's a bit smug and humorless.
Working with a team to expose them. We're small, but small.
I liked her arc. I liked how she warms up to
I guess, but she's got that sort of one female character in the gaming webcomic vibe to her. Like, she's the one who has to like roll her eyes and go, can you take this seriously all the time?
I mean, but didn't you say that Chai is like full of himself and kind of needs to be brought back down to earth a little bit? Like,
yeah, but
them acting as a foil works.
Well, she just comes across like a complete, you know, prig. Like, she's got no sense of fun at all.
Make sure you get off Vandalay Island.
I disagree.
Fine. Whatever, I guess.
Perfect.
This is your hideout? You really are a small operation.
Well, now we're plus one. You can rest on that sofa.
Luxury suite.
It is pretty funny how the game tried. Oh, I guess I don't want to spoil it. There's a revelation about her connection to some of the bad guys that is just very obvious if you look at any of them.
Yeah, I guess. I guess very like, quickly what the twist.
Because I was like, if that's not what the twist is going to be, then it's just weird that they made these characters like this.
Weird isometric level out of nowhere for the Between Missions hub.
Yeah. I do like too, so in between every level is called a track, and in between each track you come back here, and there's one later on in the game where a track ends right before a boss fight, and then you come back here, and if you talk to everybody, they're like, it's really weird that we were at the door of the boss and now we're back here at the apartment, huh? And they're like, yeah, just don't think about that too much.
Yeah. And there's another level where you get knocked out at the end of the level, and then you come back here, and if you talk to all the characters, they're all like weirdly full of praise for the main character.
Yeah. Peppermint's super praiseful, and then I think you end up seeing there's like a Twin Peaks reference with 808 doing like the weird kind of backwards red room dance.
And of course, turns out it was all a dream.
Mm-hmm.
Did you not hear me? I said let's chat before you head out.
Whoops, sorry.
Infernal Translator, with a highlighted message, we literally brought up Pizza Tower to Yahtzee earlier, asking, has Yahtzee heard of Pizza Tower, a game made as a love letter to Wario Land, especially 3?
I got too many fucking games to play, piss off.
Yeah, but are any of them a Tower of Pizza?
No. One of them's Atomic Heart.
They don't have Towers of Pizza then. And one of Although it was like an alternate universe, so maybe
one of them's supporting transphobia, apparently.
Probably doesn't have pizza as well.
Also, special attacks. Well, no, there wouldn't be any pizza. Just use them all.
Oh yeah, not invented yet. Oh, I don't know when pizza was invented. Chat, you're all such Eisenhower historians. Tell me when pizza was invented. I'll just slot in my
attack, and I'm good. Well, I assume it was imported by Italian immigrants.
And finally, here are items for some permanent.
When was Italy invented?
What's this?
I've got an idea. Well, that's an interesting question, because of course, for the longest time, Italy was more a collection of city-states rather than a coherent nation. Don't underestimate me.
I can do more than you think. All right. I really appreciate that I could say something extremely dumb like, when was Italy invented? And you would say, that's an interesting question, actually, and talk about why that's a complex answer. So thank
you. Yes, quite.
True Mandalorian with a highlighted message says, I have to confess something, everyone. I don't actually like this gameplay. Loved everything else, but I could not stand the rhythm gameplay. I'm sorry. Forgive me.
It's okay. Not everyone. Rhythm gameplay is one of those things that some people just don't get along with because they...
It's an acquired taste. You know,
lacking rhythm is a thing. It is something that can be a problem. I want more health.
So far, with the pizza question, we've gotten 1823, the 13th century, the 1800s, the 13th century again, 1734 well, and 1961.
Well, pizza is basically just bread with stuff on it, and so it's probably very arguable at what point it became the modern idea of what a pizza is.
There's a bar in North Beach in San Francisco called the Buena Vista Cafe, and they said they invented the Irish coffee, which is just whiskey and coffee. And yeah. I'm like, I have to imagine the day both of those things existed in the world. Someone was like, what if I put this in this?
Yeah, yeah. Spectra could be anything. Let's just say someone on the inside. Because coffee would be a much newer invention than whiskey, wouldn't it?
And whiskey, yeah. Up to the production facility. Using my skills and your powers, we break into the production head's office. That's Rekka. And with our luck, she's busy cleaning up your mess at QA and won't be there. We access her computer, steal the files on Spectra. Bruno Nix says, what you call pizza with tomato sauce and cheese is Naples from 1823. What do you mean, what we call pizza? What, that is pizza? Oh, bread, sauce, and cheese? What are y'all calling pizza? That made it sound like you were like an alien or like you know something more than we do.
Well, you can have pizza without tomato sauce. Can you have pizza without cheese?
Yeah, at a certain point, this is becoming like the ship of Theseus.
Yeah.
If you remove all the ingredients from pizza, is it still pizza? Who are you talking to? Niall says Irish coffee isn't just whiskey and coffee; it's a specifically made drink. It is not specifically made. It is whiskey, it is coffee, and it's a little bit of frothy cream.
Yeah, I'm with Marge on this. Irish coffee is just coffee with whiskey in it.
Yeah, if you want to put the cream, you can put the cream. Otherwise, it is just boozy coffee. As someone who's worked in coffee and drank a lot of booze, I stand behind that.
Do you know what an Irish car bomb is?
Is it a shot of whiskey in like a Guinness or in a cider or something?
Yeah, yeah. A shot of whiskey dropped into a pint of Guinness.
Imagine Irish people. You mad when people order that? Is that like, do you think like, oh, fuck off? That kind of thing?
Sorry, just got a mysterious text.
Dun, dun, dun.
Anyway, yes, rhythm. Racism against the Irish. Where was I?
Yeah. The pig, too.
A shot of spirit into some kind of beer is something I've come around to. Jack got me onto dropping a shot of gin into my Radler's grapefruit lager.
Yeah, that still seems so weird to me.
It's good stuff, and it gets you really fucked up.
Yeah, I imagine that point.
Well, Radler's isn't very high in alcohol.
That's true. It's basically it's just very junipery to me.
It's basically drinking fizzy juice.
Fizzy juice. Love fizzy juice. Radler's are really good.
Yes. Someone there should have been a character in this game called Radler's.
That would have been good.
To continue the hipster beverage naming convention. Come on, fuck me up, fam. I guess there's one criticism I have for this game is that it tends to have these long periods of going from room to room where no combat happens.
Yeah, and most of them there's like, oh, you can jump in the vents and find some shit, or there's like a notepad to read and stuff, but even short games like this, I was still like, you could probably be a little bit shorter. You could trim a little bit of that. Snake of the Garden says, coffee and whiskey was legit from the Shannon Airport in the 60s. I refuse to believe the first person to mix coffee and whiskey was in the 1960s. I refuse.
I'm sure there's a lot of people who were like stoned at 3 in the morning before then, combining literally everything in the kitchen.
Yeah.
Who discovered
it. They may have been the first to be like, oh, we could market this. This could be a thing. Especially an airport, it makes sense. People want to kind of be drunk, but also need a little bit of energy. Kyber132, thank you so much for $2 Australian. Yachts, can you get a good Hawaiian pizza over there?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, ham and pineapple. It's a classic combo.
Yeah.
I don't think there's any part of the world that claims a particular claim on that kind of pizza.
Yeah.
Although it is very popular in Australia, Hawaiian pizza.
Oh, is it? Okay, that explains the question.
I wish this game would hurry up and introduce parrying.
Oh yeah, I forgot that you don't start the game with that. Darth Payne says, what's another hipster beverage name? IPA? Do IPA? Fernet? Yeah. Kombucha?
Yeah, there definitely should have been a character called Kombucha in this game.
Yeah, yeah.
That's what Corsica should have been called.
Yeah, maybe Corsica is a tea.
Corsica is a tea?
No, I said, I don't know, maybe it is, because, like...
Someone look that up. What's Corsica, if not a misspelling of the island in the Mediterranean?
That was my first car, was a Chevy Corsica. Shout out to Chevy Corsicas. Samuel Jerome, minimum for 25 months in bonus content. Earn early access, thank you so much. Thanks for the 4-hour ZP comps, they enhance my commute. Yeah, it's our plug. Oh yeah, we put those on audio now. That's,
yeah.
The videos existed for a long time, and people said that they were listening to the videos while they slept and whatnot. And
yeah, it's slightly galling. I mean, I already said I spent half my week making funny pictures to put throughout zero punctuation, but it seems like half the audience just aren't even paying attention, so I wonder why I fucking bother.
It would be a lot easier if you just had to record the VO.
Tell me about it. I don't think anyone else could do the visuals with zero punctuation, because it's very much tied to my own stream of consciousness.
That does extra punctuation.
Yeah, but it's not the same, is it?
Probably not.
Doesn't quite have my...
je ne sais quoi?
Yeah, my certain specific, unique visual sense. Man, this game is very visually busy sometimes.
Yeah. It's like a little kid got all hopped up on sugar all day and then just threw up.
And while designing a theme park.
Someone was asking earlier, what are all the gears you're collecting all about? Unlock the ability to unlock soon, or to upgrades.
Yeah, we've already done that. The gears are just the currency for buying new combos and shit.
Yeah, new combos. You get these kind of badges that you can wear that help with like cooldowns and stuff.
Yeah, if anything, there might be a little too many like micro upgrade features in this game.
Yeah. I just did it in between tracks, though, and so, like, once every hour, I don't know, it felt very different than, like, in God of War, every time you pick something up. There you go, you got your grappling hook. You pretty much only have to pay attention to upgrade stuff once per hour if you want. And no problem there. Mike Osted, with $2 Canadian, thank you so much. Corsican pear spice is a type of tea, apparently.
Uh-huh, is that with a K?
No, it's with a C.
Didn't think so.
Womp, womp, womp.
Anyway, that's cheating. It's the name of a place before it's the name of the tea.
That is true. But the name of the car, originally.
It's like saying Belgian waffles means that Belgian is always a reference to Welsh waffles.
I mean, to be honest, they should, because Belgian waffles are delicious.
Probably nothing to do with Belgium, though.
That's
the way of this sort of thing, isn't it? Like
yeah.
French fries and English muffins.
Yeah. Wait, are English muffins not English?
No.
Or is it called something different? Oh, weird. Yeah, they should just not be called muffins. They should just have a different name. Like English muffins should be called, like, Figgy Jammers or something.
Out of my way!
we're talking about your review of Army of Two, starting with the song Two Little Boys Had Two Little Toys.
Oh, yeah. By Rolf Harris, who later turned out to be a nonce.
That's not good.
Unfortunately.
Unfortunate for a lot of people.
It's a shame how many people have turned out to be sex pests, isn't it?
It is a lot.
You know, you wouldn't think it'd be hard to not be a sex pest, and yet, no. In the entertainment industry, the fact that we are not sex pests seems to put us in the minority.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm not a sex pest, and I don't know if I can speak for you fully.
That's, yeah, it was, I appreciate you letting me speak for yourself. No, I'm pretty good. Thanks. And over on the Tiltify Trans Lifeline charity, $65. From Simmer Player 2. Thank you so much, Simmer Player 2. And Matthew V with $20. Just had to come by and donate to a good cause. Thanks for everything you do, guys. Thank you so much, Matthew V. We are almost at $5,500.
Nice.
What a time to be alive.
Oh, look, a New Game Plus door. A door for New Game Plus.
Yeah. There's like nine... I think each world might have its own like combat challenge arena.
Each world's got... secret doors you can only unlock post-ending.
Yeah.
How do you feel about that sort of thing? Do you find that annoying?
No, not really. Because I also didn't, like, when I finished the game, I was like, well, I'm probably done for now. I didn't really have any desire to go back. But, like, if I, like, really loved the game, I'd probably go back and try them out. Because, again, I'm thinking of, like, the games of the era that this was inspired by, the Resident Evil 4s, where... so much of the stuff unlocks after you complete it, whether it's mercenary mode or the different costumes or the unlimited
Leon's
ammo.
Leon's gangster outfit and the infinite
get your Chicago typewriter. Grand Autismo with $2. Thank you so much. I love this game. Yay,
it's good, isn't it?
And Hustwee TV with $1.99. Is Toffee in the room with you today, Yahtzee?
Yeah, he's in my coat as always. Looks like, sounds like he's having a very restful sleep. I don't feel like interrupting. Not now, anyway. Maybe the end of the stream. So much random bollocks, and so much you can actually climb on and find hidden stuff.
Yeah.
That's what we like to see.
These statues were weird. There's a bunch of them in the game. You just beat the shit out of them for a long time, and they just give you a bunch of stuff.
Yeah. I guess it's kind of cathartic.
Yeah. I guess, maybe that's what it's supposed to be. Beating up the handsome Jack-like guy. And Hustwee TV with $1.99 dono. Two more dollars because Yahtzee is a good pet owner. Congrats on being a good pet owner.
It's not difficult. As I say, just as it's pretty easy to not be a sex pest, it's also pretty easy not to be an asshole to your pets.
There you go. Antifar subscribed over on Prime on Twitch. Thank you so much, Antifar. Oh yeah, Snake Nerd. Did we? Did I tell you about how Power Wash Simulator got the Lara Croft Manor DLC and the Final Fantasy VII DLC that's coming to it?
Oh shit! I need to play that some more.
So you can power wash various things from Final Fantasy VII, like the bar and the motorcycle. My question is, if you could have anything from any game to power wash, what would you want to add to the Power Wash Simulator?
Scrub down the entirety of Super Mario Sunshine.
Oh my god, take me just to Delfino Island and just muck it up. Oh.
Just to clean it properly this time.
Yeah. As opposed to Mario's just superficial cleaning.
Yeah, he didn't even use the soap.
No, Yeah, whatever whatever germs are in that goop, they're just littering that island. Simple Simon with a $5 dono, thank you so much. The devs put those gold statues in the game for you to smash as a small tribute to Fight Club. They just want to destroy something beautiful.
Okay, then. Now to break some more boxes. Now the tiresome chore of breaking the death robots is over. Oh gee, I wonder if there's a secret place hidden cunningly somewhere in the environment.
Dun dun dun! There is. There's a secret right there. And Grand Autismo with another $5. Thank you so much. I retort with $5 more. I love this game, but more this time. Hey there, Chai. Well, there you go. You're only the game's number two.
I love it more. I love it than you. I'm the best at liking games.
As this leads to Grand just constantly giving money. No, I need to one-up him.
I have a reputation for being one of the big game haters online. So when I like games, it has actual impact.
Hmm. How does it feel to be a hater?
I didn't really try out many of these special abilities.
Neither did I.
There's one you get later that's just the maximum amount of damage for the shortest amount of time. So I just stuck with that.
Yeah, I mostly... I was mostly just buying like items and upgrades. Like I upgraded my chip slot or whatever, so... Mostly by the end, I just had everyone's cooldown time for calling them in for battle much lower. So I could pretty much cycle through all three of them constantly in a battle.
Yeah, that as well.
So Peppermint, this spectrum thingy? What's that about?
Dicevolt with a $2 donation. The box breaking feels actually feels quite flow breaking.
If you say so.
It's the flow.
Doesn't really kill
the game.
The
has a specific flow in combat, and in combat you're not breaking boxes.
Yeah, like, it's important. It's important with a game like this, with sort of requires sort of intense concentration, to have a lot of downtime in between the fights. Yep. I find.
I think that's why these kind of liminal spaces in between combat arenas are, you can kind of turn your brain off and just. Amble around and wander a little bit and be like, oh, what's in that corner? And the platforming never gets too tough. The puzzles aren't really tricky at all. So then when you enter combat again, you can kind of give it your all.
You're supposed to use the box to practice hitting things to the beat, I suppose.
Uh-huh.
And that's when I taught Rekka everything she knows about production. Your tales are nothing but lies. Like you would know. You just clean the floor.
I'm Grand Autismo with one more $5 saying you cannot beat me on this yacht.
Well, I already have. Because you're the one giving me money. I don't know if you noticed. Okay, fine. You have beaten me. I shall console myself with all the dollars.
Oh my god. Dollars are filthy, though, so don't use them to like wipe your tears or anything. You'll get weird green eye.
And then I feel very jealous towards people.
That's what Green Eye's all about, yeah. Storm Templar says, gents, who's the best waifu in this game? There's not a ton of waifu material in this game.
No, there's Peppermint and Corsica, and maybe Mimosa if you're into that.
Yeah.
Hey, I wasn't quite finished with the last fight before you spawned in more guys. Rude.
Monday says, and Rekka. Rekka's pretty good. And I don't know if waifu material, but I like Rekka. When I first started this game, they kind of introduced that there were the, whatever, five or six minions to the main boss. I thought the game was going to have kind of a Mega Man thing to it, where after each boss fight, you end up getting their whatever their ability or power is that you use for combat and traversal. That was not the case.
Yeah, I got more of a No More Heroes-y vibe. Like, having to go down the list of the committee structure.
Yeah,
where you can take on the big boys.
Yeah. Kind of kill building your way there. Varen with a $5 donation, thank you so much. This was definitely a game that once I finished the main story, I actually wanted to go back through and complete everything. So satisfying.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think there is a lot of people too. Amy said she did the same thing.
I probably would have if I felt so inclined.
Yeah.
In contrast, I finished the Hogwarts Legacy main campaign yesterday, and it said, "Hey, keep playing up to level 34," and I was like, "Piss off."
There you go. Yeah, it's the rare open world game that makes me want to continue playing after I roll credits.
Yeah, but then
it's rare any game, I guess, that makes me want to play after I roll credits.
Well, that's because it represents getting the rest of your week back for people like us,
or at least having to move on to whatever the next thing is. And there's countless games in the backlog. How did you feel about kind of the amount of information that you get in fights, especially later on in the game when there start being a lot of enemies you're fighting, and some of them are doing long distance projectiles, and some of them need to have their shields broken in only certain ways? Did you ever feel like it became overwhelming?
Well, funnily enough, the fact that it's all to a rhythm sort of helped with that, you know?
Yeah.
When you know things were only going to happen on the beat, including enemy attacks, it's easier to get your thoughts in order and sort of internalize the battlefield and figure out what your priorities are.
Yeah, and it does the Doom thing of kind of slowly folding in more and more enemy types as the game goes on. So you start with pretty basic ones, and then you get to ones that need to have their shields broken by X or stunned by Y, and the end of the game feels like a final exam by throwing them all at you.
I always feel like the late stages of a Doom game start to feel a bit static when they stop introducing new enemies. And just becomes, here's a sequence of the usual lads and a big Baron of Hell at the end. And that's like 90% of the fights in the last level.
Yeah, that's a pretty good point.
Excuse me.
Yeah, congratulating every department but security in her Armstrong email. That's a corporate slap in the face.
Chumpley says not enough numbers on the screen. I'm very happy that there's no numbers on the screen. Well, numbers as in every time you hit something or get hit.
Yeah.
Kamja Ninja, Mikami was a producer on this game, not the director, but I think mostly Mikami doesn't, he said in interviews before that he kind of wants to stop directing and he wants to like pass the baton on to the next generation.
He was executive producer, which, as I said in the review, could mean a lot of things.
Sure.
Sometimes executive producers take creative control, sometimes they don't.
Yeah.
It's really up to them.
Yeah. And the again, John Johannes, the guy credited as the director of the game, has been the one on all the interview circuits and everything. I mean, maybe part of that is because he's American and speaks English, but this very much feels like his baby.
Then again, as I said, there's a lot of it that feels like it's got Mikami sort of vibe to it.
Yeah. Yeah, especially those aforementioned sort of stranger one-off games.
I mean, we say this like reminds us of like a PS2 era game, and Mikami was sort of ruling the roost around that time.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, had probably one of the most prolific runs of that generation. Yeah, the game does a lot of, it does a lot of small intangible things, like things I'm even noticing, because it's the first time I'm watching someone play the game as opposed to playing it myself, but just small visual flourishes in combat that tell you information
which you
and
don't
also
notice,
just give you a dopamine drift.
Which you don't notice, but your brain does.
Exactly, yeah, I guess I subconsciously notice it. Whereas it feels like the lazy thing to do is just be like, well, put some numbers, because the numbers are the way to get the dopamine hit. But this doesn't have to rely on that, which I appreciate.
Be able to bypass security on that one. It's a rough route, though.
Humane Shield with a $5 donation. Thank you so much. Would the Escapist do a live stream of the Gothic series? Also, off topic, Chicago Wizards are better than British ones.
Probably not. And okay, then.
What are Chicago Wizards?
I assumed it was like a sports team.
No, there's the Chicago Bulls, the White Sox, the Cubs, the Blackhawks, the Bears.
Okay. Maybe it's a reference to the Dresden Files books.
Is that from Chicago?
I think it's set in Chicago.
That makes sense. The Gothic series. I don't think I've ever played a Gothic game. Have you?
Nope.
To be honest, I'm not even sure what kind of... are those like shooters or immersive sims? Action role-playing franchise?
Do not know.
Created by Piranha Bytes. I only know Piranha Bytes because I feel like Nick brings up their name a lot. Nick's always talking about his fucking Piranha Bytes. Oh, they made that game Elix, which was apparently not very good. And Risen. If I'm being perfectly honest, we will probably not do a Gothic replay. We generally do replays of big franchises that we either really love or that people have a blind spot in, or sometimes both, which is how we got stuff like Dead Space and Metal Gear and God of War and currently Half-Life. Michael Wolf says, Yahtzee, you should do a live ZP with Amy at the tapings in March. Well, you can't do a ZP live.
No.
It takes a week. He has to play a full game, and then he has to write it, and then he has to record it, and then he has to edit it.
And if I record it, I have to cut out all the pauses for breath and shit.
Yes. And to make sure everyone, if it needs reiteration, the walking trip is quite literally a work trip.
Hey, it's 2D animation again.
They did it.
They used the smoke cloud to transition to 2D animation, the sneaky
buggers.
Those
tricksters. Damian Glenn, maybe we'll do Dead Space Remake after Half-Life, but the Half-Life series is going to take us a while.
Transition back. It's CD. It's cel-shaded 3D again.
You know what this game should have had? You know what more games need? Remember commentary modes? You know, like, speaking of Half-Life, Valve games did commentary modes really well. Firewatch had a good commentary mode. Portal had a really good commentary mode.
And I must say, I'm impressed you are still alive, lad.
What are these? Electric barriers? Come on.
Angie Parr says Smoke Cloud is the new shuffling through a narrow crevasse.
Now we can use Peppermint in battle.
temporal displacement.
She's basically the only ranged attack, besides the grappling hook.
You could have been here this whole time.
Didn't think you needed me, Mr. Confident. Doesn't look like you can make this jump. But see that switch?
Let me guess.
Yep, call me in. I can activate those for you.
Ugh, you sound like a video game tutorial.
Lol.
Oh, they referenced video games. That's the thing we're in.
Peppermint,
come on!
Jim on Toast 89, thank you so much. Been a member for 9 months in bonus content using the monthly comment to say, Yahtzee, do you have a dream cast for the Jacques McKeown movies? I thought of Harrison Ford for Robert Blaze, but that might be too on the nose.
A Sega dream cast.
Wagga wagga.
Well, I never really considered Robert Blaze. I always pictured the main character as someone like Clive Owen. Someone who had that sort of pulp action hero good looks that have faded with age.
Gotcha. I feel like I don't see Clive on a lot anymore. I hope he's doing all right.
I assume he's fine. Oh, bugger.
And Pablo Cardona, thank you so much for the donation. Yats, what would you say is the most important thing for an aspiring writer besides writing every day?
I was going to say writing every day. Shit.
Yes.
read a lot of that every day as well.
Yeah. Yeah, I think most people who create also consume quite a bit. Consuming is good.
Consume.
Consume. Obey. Products. Consume. Obey. Kevin Wolf with a $5 dono. Marty or Yats, what is your favorite / least hated opera or musical?
Probably Les Misérables.
I like a lot of music. Yeah, I don't know. I don't think I've ever sat through an entire opera, if I'm being honest. Plenty of musicals. I like Assassin. I liked Wicked. I like Phantom of the Opera. I like Sweeney Todd.
Can't go wrong with Les Misérables, if you ask me.
You can't. Yeah, well, you could. The movie went wrong.
Okay, fine.
It's a pretty bad movie.
But those
don't
songs get
Russell Crowe sing.
Those songs get me pumped when Russell Crowe's not singing them.
Cornish Cream Tea 07 with a £2 donation. So much. The art style is like if Persona 5 and Jet Set Radio had a baby.
If you say so.
They did say so.
I tend to think
underneath a £2 donation.
I tend to put it somewhere between Jet Set Radio and Scooby-Doo.
I think by Persona it was mostly the HUD elements, like literally just then. I think when your special move unlocks, when you can use your special move, it kind of looks like it's tearing a page from a magazine.
Oh yeah,
which is very much a Persona thing. I also, don't yell at me, I also think the visuals feel very inspired by Sunset Overdrive.
Only because I'd say they like Sunset Overdrive and this sort of share influences.
Okay, yeah, that makes sense. They draw from the same pool.
Jet Set Radio mainly.
Mm-hmm.
Or Jet Grind Radio.
Oh, that went better than expected.
Filthy Americans.
Dumb title.
Gelden, yeah, that's right. Returnal came out today on PC. Did you like Returnal?
Yeah. I guess not.
You got one, and one, it's really good. And I know Nick fucking loved it.
So that was the first game we streamed together.
I think it was. I was on my little laptop. I didn't even have a desktop yet. We were such babies, such summer children back then.
I know, right? Aha. Uh-huh.
Oh no.
Here's the
locked door number two.
More new game plus doors.
Yeah, apparently according to Amy, those are just challenge arenas, which is kind of like it's not like, it's right full on fun stuff to do beyond it. Which I guess challenge, I mean, the combat is kind of the game, so that makes sense.
Yeah.
Jason Tudor Returnal looks fun, but it's $80 here in Canada. Sweet fancy Moses, that's a lot of dollars.
Your abilities. Have you felt any side effects, like someone temporarily appearing beside you?
Yeah, that's peppermint.
Well, it seems very useful. You can pull this peppermint. I can even tell this.
Blah blah blah. Okay, yeah, fine. Yes, I know. Shut up.
It looks like I hope this foreign existence doesn't come between you and I.
Eon asking about the new goal of Nick playing 360 games. It is not 360 arcade games. It is Max Payne 3, Alan Wake.
Just Remedy games?
Vanquish. It's weird. I don't know what's going on. Nick just chose four games he wants to play and kind of bundled them together. And honestly, okay. I like all four of the games, so I was kind of behind it. And then maybe one of the Splinter Cell games?
Tell you something I've been meaning to reassess. Prince of Persia 2008. I've been meaning to replay that at some point.
It's beautiful. Whether it's good remains to be seen.
I feel like I sort of was sort of knee jerk against it because I hate Nolan North's character in that game. The way he voiced that character.
Well, and you also like the original Prince. Not the original Prince, but the original remake Prince.
Yeah, I like Sands of Time a lot.
Did you review Prince Persia 08?
Yep.
Oh, yeah, because you started the year before that. Yeah, that had, I remember that getting really, that got pretty mixed reception at the time. It also feels like it's not one of those games that, like, it doesn't feel like the pendulum swung back around over time, and, like, people don't talk about, just don't talk about it that much.
No.
People still talk about Sands of Time, but I don't hear people
talking about
that.
I think people still remember it more fondly than they remember Prince of Persia, The Forgotten Sands.
Yeah, and what was there? Because there was a trilogy, right?
Yeah,
both two and three were kind of. Yeah.
There was Sands of Time, Warrior Within, Two Thrones. That was the Sands trilogy, and then they made Prince of Persia 2008, which was a completely new canon, and then they made Forgotten Sands, which was a sequel to the Sands trilogy because they were cashing in on the movie adaptation of Prince of Persia: Sands of Time.
Did they make a Prince of Persia movie game, or was that what Forgotten Sands?
That's what Forgotten Sands was. That was the tie-in to the Prince of Persia movie with Jake Gyllenhaal.
Oh, that's dumb. Yeah, and I guess then they were going to kind of reboot it, and then that transformed into Assassin's Creed.
I think Forgotten Sands was after Assassin's Creed.
I mean, I think 08 was after Assassin's Creed, too. Assassin's Creed as well. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, and then it feels like for a while Assassin's Creed was like one of the biggest franchises on Earth, and they just quietly broke up with Prince of Persia for a long time.
Yeah. No news on that remake, eh?
No. I mean, at least they, instead of being like, just fucking put it out there, the dummies will buy it, they were like, this is bad. This,
I suppose,
could hurt the brand, let's not release this.
It's the right time for remakes. Probably why the Dead Space remake came out. Because, you know, now the live services have all died. Gaming's entered a sort of what the fuck do you people want period, which is usually prime remastering times.
Yeah.
Hence Metroid Prime as well, I suppose.
Yeah, Metroid Prime, Resident Evil 4 in just a month or so.
Okay, now I can upgrade. Peppermint's abilities, but I never did.
Yeah, it seems like with all these upgrades, you can make the combat system pretty deep and advanced. Yeah. And I never really did that.
Alrighty.
Monday, I would be shocked if Dino Crisis isn't on the list of games that Capcom's currently working on. A Dino Crisis remake or anything like that. People love dinosaurs. People love these good-looking Capcom remakes. Doesn't seem like there's a lot of competition in the dino space, especially in the AAA space.
Quite. Turok Dinosaur Hunter?
Yeah.
There's that.
I think. There is that. There was that arc. There's Arc 2 starring Vin Diesel, which got announced like a long time ago and still isn't out.
You kill a Tyrannosaurus in the first Tomb Raider game.
That is true. And she's just unfazed by it.
Well, few things did phase original Lara Croft.
Yeah.
Because they couldn't afford the voice acting.
Right angles phase. It's hard to take right angles. As the original Lara Croft, so that faced her.
Thanks to you!
Hey, who is doing all the hard work here?
It wouldn't be so hard if you just listened to me to begin with.
Snipe, snipe, chemistry.
For all workers who haven't yet entered the lottery for Armstrong Festival tickets, now's your chance. You won't want to miss this show.
These pigeons are the source of my discontent.
Who owns the rights to Turok anyway? I do not know.
Acclaim?
That's
and now
not
they're
a company
dead?
Anymore. That's definitely not a company anymore.
What happened to all of Acclaim's IPs?
Mortal Kombat was one of them.
No.
Yeah,
That wasn't Acclaim. That was Midway, wasn't it?
Oh, no. I think you're right. Dissolved. Rest in peace. The last Turok game, the Turok remake, published by Disney.
Serious?
Yeah, the one from like the 360 generation.
The terrible one.
Terrible one, yeah. Developed by Propaganda Games.
The terrible one that was a first-person shooter with Ron Perlman in it.
Correct. Propaganda Games was a first-party Disney studio. They made Turok, they made Tron Evolution, and then they never made another game again.
So. I remember some people saying Tron Evolution was good. I never really gave it much time.
Alright. Jomo Slomo with 50 Norwegian kroner. Thank you so much. I've seen your Resident Evil 4 streams, Marty. I hope remake keeps my two favorite moments, the chopper pushing the tower and Leon and Ash convo at the machine.
Couldn't we just not remake it and just keep the old one since we just like the old one so much?
The old one's still very good. I'm very worried that everything they've shown of the remake has been realistic, gritty, spooky, and yeah, all from the first like 3 hours of the game.
That's the concern. They did well with the RE2 make, but there's going to be diminishing returns setting in at some point.
But RE2 is also less like RE4 is like unabashedly weird in a way that RE2 was not.
Also, RE2 benefited from a remake in ways RE4 do not.
Sure, the original still had tank controls.
Yeah, the original had potential that just could have been brought out better.
Mm-hmm. As long as Leon still says, hey, it's that dog, I'll be happy.
Blah, 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 blah. Hey, it's the Evil Within robots.
Bigger, stronger. Is this promo for Rekka or motivation for the rest of us?
Specifically, the Evil Within robots from the first Evil Within game.
Yeah.
Definitely not the second one.
Yeah, for you and your partner.
In the second one, the main character was just a hairy dad.
Was a hairy dad, yeah.
Here need to know they ain't ever getting out of that hole they dug themselves into. This world is sick, dark, sad.
But we are supposed to help.
Help? Impossible. We just mask the reality, give an illusion we care. We can't change anything.
I can see this confusing people who don't get the reference.
This poster
says, yes.
It says the truth.
Like, why is HR like a hard-boiled detective?
Yeah. And why do they have such long monologues?
Mm-hmm. Storm Templar with a highlighted message over in Twitch. If you had all the money and could hire any studio to remake any game, what would it be?
I would pay them all to not remake shit. That's what I would do.
So much money. But you yourself, there has to be like a game that like was disappointing but had a kernel of something better in it that you think.
I guess I'd remake my own game, The Consuming Shadow, because the graphics
would you want to remake
shit.
That?
Me.
Nope, you're not a studio. I mean, you are a studio, technically.
I'm a studio of one.
There you go. Gotta be aggressive.
Let's see if we can beat this boss before the end of the stream.
Oh, that would be thrilling. Old Hunter says, can you explain the reference? Those two characters, those two little robots, they show up. You can find them at various points throughout the game, and they visually are representative of the main character and his partner from The Evil Within 1.
See that.
Yes.
Who are detectives. But the characters in this game are kind of like these HR investigators who bemoan the poor working conditions and the danger of the world and everything.
I don't know. Fight?
There's also more on-the-nose references to Evil Within. Like, you can find the save mirrors at various points in the game, and they make scary noises. Like Fleur de... Was it Fleur de Lou? I think that's a song. Jumbly Wumbly with a highlighted message says, by the way, Marty, the guys in Resident Evil 4 that sound like they're saying call Hitler or saying coñedo, which either means picking stuff up or fucking, more of the latter as a general insult, but badly made. Yeah, it makes no sense. None of the guys sound like they're saying call Hitler, a group of enemies in Resident Evil 4. Kanji Ninja said apparently Turok had a game released in 2019. I had no idea. That was just a port of Turok 64.
Yeah, I think Switch like that.
And other stuff. Yeah, I don't think there's been a new Turok game since the aforementioned 2008, 2009 one.
Not bad. Very
oh, okay. And the other one says more. That's pretty good, Jumbly. Very funny. Eric Cartman with a $2 donation. I don't know why, but this game's giving me PS2 vibes. If you want to know why it's giving you PS2 vibes, watch most of this stream and we explain why it gives you PS2 vibes. And yes, you are not alone in that. Don't you worry.
Ow.
And Dower Dodger with another $100 donated to the Trans Lifeline Charity. Thank you so much, Dower Dodger, saying, Yahtzee, may we have your best Lister impression for charity. If you need to wait until after you're fighting, I understand. I'm
trying to think of a line. Sorry, I'm focusing on this fight. Sorry.
Please focus. Please focus. That's fine. We'll get to that after.
She sure does.
Not the pipes.
Okay.
One neat thing about the game is absolutely we've only seen kind of two boss fights, but each one feels very different.
Sure it, sure do.
Yeah, they have different quirks to them. Sometimes like the fights feel like different genres, all folded into rhythm. But
I like the one where you have to defeat them by using up their production budget.
That's really good, yeah. And Slow Descent with a 100 Norwegian kroner donation over on YouTube. Thank you so much, Slow Descent. And Same Old Satellite with a £2 donation. Thank you so much. Penny, for your thoughts on Sayonara Wild Hearts.
Oh, I haven't actually played it. I haven't actually played it. I just know of it.
Oh, I thought it's great. I love Simoga. I was a big fan of it. You think I'll lose? Can you do your Lister now? Or are you still fighting?
I can't remember. There might be a quick time event still.
Nope.
There we go.
Rest in peace.
From this period in history, we derive the phrase, beware of Greeks bearing gifts. Whereas I think we should derive the phrase, beware of Trojans, they're complete smegheads.
Lister is a man from Red Dwarf?
Yes.
Or a woman from Red Dwarf? A character from Red Dwarf?
Yes.
There you go. And Slow Descent with that donation said, came late, have some cash. Thank you
Thanks
so much.
Thanks you.
You did great.
This is a screensaver, Jai. Spectra has designed to interface with user perception and reasoning.
This gives okay, let's all enjoy this cutscene, then we can all piss off.
Yay!
Would you make that thing stop? I'm trying to concentrate. What did you just do?
You said make it stop.
Do you think these are going to be five bosses you have to fight later on in the game?
Do you think? No, I think one of them is the character who you win round to your side and who becomes a party member.
But is still a boss fight.
Yeah. Well, of course. And naturally, they're much more powerful during the boss fight than they are once you control them.
Is this some sort of joke?
Oh,
Now this is a juicy meeting.
Do you want me to reschedule this?
Zanzo, I think you're muted, honey.
Is Zanzo a food?
Oh, I was going to say...
Good question, I don't know what Zanzo is. Right
away. Yes, sir.
Go ahead, send whatever you want. See this? Peppermint and I are gonna kick your ass with your own tech.
I don't
tech.
Know.
Peppermint.
Doesn't look like
that's
it.
Not enough. Check
maybe
out
short
arm.
For Zanzibar?
Guitar, slam mm-hmm. it down.
Their favorite Halo 2 level.
Idiot! Come on!
Darth Bane, Rockfort's. Rockfort's a.
Cheese. Yes.
Zanzibar. Cheese. Yeah, Zanzibar Land was one of the settings of the early 2D Metal Gear games.
Yes.
Not sure why you needed a land at the end of Zanzibar, but.
To differentiate it from the other Zanzibar, I assume.
That's true. So that was very nice of them. And Steve Horwath with a $5 dono. Yahtzee, do you think of songs? What do you think of the songs they chose for the game's soundtrack? Forgive me if this has already been asked.
They're fine, I guess.
Yeah, I didn't think any were like mind blowing. And I don't know. I like the game's regular.
They do.
It's funny. I like the game's regular music. I don't love it, which is kind of funny.
They pulled out the perfect drug for the final boss, but I kept fucking up, so it could never really kick in for me.
So it's kind of frustrating. Yeah.
Yeah.
Hey, whoa! What are you?
Confusingly, the cat appears to have some kind of independent intelligence when it's not just being puppeted by one of your NPC support characters.
Yeah, so you start to feel bad for the cat, and you're like, oh my god, are they like hijacking your mind? And...
But it's a robot cat, so it's fine.
I don't know, I've seen enough movies. We should be worried.
Yo, what the?
Still doubting?
But you made me say that. Couldn't Vandalay have designed this for, you know... researcher or something?
Only you wouldn't find this suspicious. The point is, they can, and I need to stop that.
Well, I wish you good luck.
Bye.
Joan J, in all caps, this music's not bad. I didn't say the music was bad. I just said that it wasn't one of the better things in the game. Doesn't mean it's bad. I think the music's perfectly fine.
As I say, it does the job.
Our own little weird indie three piece. But like any job, could be done better.
A weird indie three-piece? What's that, a kind of swimsuit?
Nah.
Anyway. We'll just see if I get any rewards.
Goodies.
Oh, yay. I got Peppermint's legs.
Yay. Peppermint's legs.
Anyway. Probably her most agreeable part. Well, thanks for watching the post-CP stream, everybody. If you're interested in my opinion on High... I almost said High on Life there. Hi-Fi Rush.
I've done the same thing. You've done two High games in like a month.
You can go and watch my Zero Punctuation that came out on EscapistMagazine.com today, or you can watch it on YouTube if you're a YouTube member or a Patreon subscriber, and why wouldn't you be? And you could also watch a review of High on Life if that's your thing. I've got one of those too. What else we got? Well, tomorrow I've also got an Extra Punctuation dropping for members. And tomorrow afternoon it's our next Sea of Thieves stream. Well, I'm sure we'll come up with something to do.
Probably some piracy.
Yeah.
And Jack won't be there because Jack made plans. So we're going to, I assume Nick is working on. I told Nick to grab a fourth. I have not heard back from Nick.
Well, he thought you said grab a 40, and he's been
Don't grab a 40.
He's been drinking
ever
since.
He can grab a 40. That's perfectly fine. Also, two last donos. Stunmun69 with 100 bits over on Twitch. Hi-Fi Rush and Cosmic Shake are much better at humor than Forspoken. Agreed. And Pablo Cardona, I don't know what Cosmic Shake actually is, so I agree with one of those. And Pablo Cardona with 4,000 COP. Last tip before pissing off, thanks lads. And Humane Shield with a $4.99 dono. What are your guilty pleasure games that you enjoy but are embarrassed to admit you like? Don't be embarrassed about anything you like. Like the things you like and like them full-throatedly. But don't be weird and annoying about them.
Don't start debates. We're finishing the stream. Read the room, asshole.
Oh, Humane Shield. I think you're great. Don't be embarrassed about your interests, but also don't make your interests your identity.
Yeah, that doesn't help. I'll see you next week for the next week's EP, which is on the Dead Space remake, before anyone asks, and it'll be Hogwarts Legacy the week after that. All right.
And we'll be back in an hour for Breakout. Come back in an hour.
Yeah.
It'll be Breakout. We did it. Bye, everybody.
Bye, then. Here's a cute dog.
Dogs.